Today we're going to be designing and building an open-air test bench for a Raspberry Pi 5, and not just a simple stand. I designed it from the ground up to make testing, as well as showcasing hats, accessories and custom setups way easier. I wanted something compact and practical, a test bench that keeps everything open and accessible, but still looks good on my desk. It holds a Pi 5 on the base, and above that I've added a mount for a hat. It allows easy access to the Pi and the hat, as well as monitoring and buttons to start and control the execution of test scripts. To start out, I designed the stand in Fusion 360. It accommodates a Raspberry Pi flat on the desk, with a hat mounted at an angle above it. This can be an NVMe adapter, an AI accelerator, or another Pi-compatible add-on. I went with this rather than installing the hat on the Pi, so that I still have clear access to the Pi's CPU, PCIe connector, and GPIO pins. This way I can also add external accessories and use a range of coolers. The main components are going to be milled from aluminium, but can also be 3D printed. The test and stats board alongside it will be made up as a single-sided PCB. This is one of my favorite parts of the build. I designed the PCB in EasyEDA, a free online PCB design tool. Although small, this PCB adds a lot of functionality to the test bench. There's an OLED display that'll be used to run my stats script, showing the Pi's IP address, CPU temperature, and resource utilization. Alongside it is an RGB LED, which can also be customized, but I'll set it up to change color based on the CPU load. And beneath the LED are three tactile push buttons. You can use these to map custom functions. I'll have them starting and stopping services, or launching benchmarking utilities. To make up the components for this build, I'm going to be using the Carvera Air. Makera recently sent it to me to try out, and I've added it to the original that I backed on their Kickstarter campaign last year. The Carvera Air is a really useful manufacturing tool for a home workshop. It enables you to mill wood, plastic and aluminium, to laser engrave components, and even manufacture your own PCBs, all in one unit. Let's start out by making up the three aluminium pieces for the test bench. From the design in Fusion 360, we then need to go into the manufacturing space and create our tool parts for milling them out. The two sides of the stand are identical, so technically I could use one CNC file to make up both, but I wanted to clean the face up on the outside of each, so I've made a mirrored file for each side. Then we also have a separate file for the middle joiner. To make up each side, we need to load a piece of stock into the bed. The Carvera Air will then do an auto-leveling operation, which probes the surface of the stock at a range of points across the surface. We can then switch to a 1/8 inch end mill to face the surface of the stock. The Carvera Air doesn't have any automatic tool changer, but it's an easy lever-operated process to swap between tools, and the LED bar on the top tells you which tool to change to. Next, we can drill our holes for the joiner by switching to a 2mm drill bit. Then we can switch back to the end mill to contour the outside edges. Small tabs keep the part in place in the stock when it's complete, and we'll need to remove this in post-processing. Now we need to repeat the process for the second side. Next, we can use an offcut from the first side to make up the joiner. This doesn't have any holes in the top surface, so it'll be done entirely with a single 1/8 inch end mill. Now I need to remove the parts from the stock and get the tabs cleaned up. While I'm doing that, let's start on the PCB. I'm also going to be making that up on the Carvera Air, using their PCB fabrication pack. It's a single-sided design, so I just need a single-sided PCB blank. This only has copper on one side, which is the side that we'll be engraving our traces onto. So I'll load that into the bed, and then let the Carvera Air do its probing and auto-leveling sequence. We can then start engraving our traces. The tiny 0.2mm engraving bit does a really clean job of this. I was worried that some of my traces might be a bit small, but it doesn't look like we'll have any issues with them. Next, we can apply the UV curing solder mask. This is applied with a roller and then cured for 15 minutes using a UV lamp. In hindsight, I probably applied a bit too much solder mask too quickly, but for a first attempt it looks okay, and it's on the back in any case, so it won't be visible. We can then use the mask removal tool to remove the solder mask from the pads that we'll be soldering onto. Then a range of drill bits drill the holes for the components. Lastly, I'll switch to a 0.8mm corn bit to cut the PCB out. With the stand components removed and cleaned up, I then drilled and tapped the holes for the joiner with M2 threads to attach it to the legs. The PCB doesn't really need any finishing off once removed from the stock. I quite like the bare look and colour. We can then add the PCB components, which are all soldered into place. We've got an I2C OLED display, an RGB LED, and 3 tactile push buttons, along with 6 resistors to complete the circuits. A short lead connects the PCB to the Pi's GPIO pins. Assembly is then straightforward. The stand is assembled with 4 M2 button head screws. Four M2.5x6mm standoffs are used to mount the Pi. The standoff can be mounted either way around, but I like them with the studs up for this application, as it's easy to then install and remove the Pi. Some brass inserts act as thumb screws to hold it in place, rather than having to use a screwdriver each time. For the hat, I've gone with a slightly different approach. I've mounted the hat directly onto the frame, since there aren't any solder joints on the underside of this hat. The hat screws also hold the PCB in place alongside it. And that's my open air test bench complete. Everything stays in position with good airflow all around the Pi and the hat, and testing's now made much easier too. The OLED stats display shows the Pi's key system stats like resource utilization, CPU temperature, and the Pi's IP address. The LED alongside it is currently running as a CPU load snapshot. It runs green at low load, and will progressively shift through yellow and onto red at full CPU load. Using the buttons underneath the LED, I can start and stop scripts, or initiate actions like toggling services or the OLED display on and off, or shutting down and rebooting the Pi, even if it's running headless. These are all programmable through a Python script, so they can be easily customized to show or carry out other tasks too. The extra weight from the metal stand, PCB and hat make the Pi less likely to move around when cables are plugged in, and it looks great on my desk. If you found this video useful or inspiring, please leave a like and subscribe to my channel for more Raspberry Pi builds, tech reviews and maker projects. Also, let me know in the comment section below what features you'd like to see me add to the test bench. If you'd like to try out a project like this for yourself, check out the Carvera Aeon Makera's website, which I'll link to in the video description. It's a great workshop addition for tinkering with electronics and SBCs, as it allows you to quickly make up your own PCBs, as well as plastic, carbon fiber, and aluminium components. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.